Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on ARM microcontroller and embedded systems. This is lecture number 18. So in this lecture we will be just discussing about the basics of the assembly level language program again, and we will see here how the assembly level language program and C programs are interlinked. Okay, means without C program or without assembly level language program or instructions, so it is not possible to just compile every program. So except a few simple programs, so in almost all programs we require the usage of assembly as well as C programs. So first let us see here how we can use assembly level language. So this we have already discussed in lecture number 11. So there we have seen the format and all. So slight changes are required here. According to that we need to follow the things. Okay, now how to interface between assembly and a C. So that we have to check here first. Okay. Now if you check the interfacing things here, why it is required is, first point, when embedded assembly or embedded program is used in C program code. So that means, so along with the ASM codes, the assembly code, whenever we require some C language instructions also, it is something like mixed language type. We will be using both C as well as assembler instructions. And also there is a need of interaction whenever a C program code calls a functions or a subroutine implemented in .asm file. So some interrupt file or some LCD program you might have written in .asm and you want to execute through C platform. So if you have that assembly program for LCD in your working directory, just you can call with the header file. So that we have seen in the previous lecture also, and almost in the labs we are aware of that. Okay, and also when an assembly program calls a C function or a subroutine, so that is the condition. So these are not only the three conditions which are required to provide the interface between assembly and C. So there are several examples. So let us restrict it to these three simple conditions. So if you consider the overall things, so here it is based on a standard called as AEPCS, that is ARM Architecture Procedure Call and Standard. So now if we consider a simple example wherein a calling program means the main program, it needs to pass the parameters to a subroutine or a function. So it something like if you want to have a log or the record, so just like you can assume like the Google Forms also. Google Form, the form which we send the link, it will be like a main program, and the responses what we get from you people, that will be assembled. So the all those responses can be considered as a subroutine programs. So we want to pass those things. Okay, so it is only for understanding, not here. So just consider the concept like that. So a calling program needs to pass the parameters to subroutine or a function. Okay, so something like if you are using a formula continuously in your program, if that formula is say around 10 lines, so every time instead of introducing that formula in your program, you can have a subroutine program or a subprogram. So whenever that formula is required in your execution, we can just call that formula program. So you should be aware of with which name or with what name we have saved that subroutine or a required function. So similarly here, let us assume that we are using the register R0 to R3. So we are using the registers R0 to R3 for storing the results or maybe retrieving the results. So R0 to R3 are required in a subroutine program. So where if you consider for example R0 may be used to pass the first parameter and so on R1, R2 and R3. So it is in a sequence if you assume. So similarly now if you take R0 is used for returning a value at the end of a function. So that means after executing the subroutine program, we know R0, R1 and R2 are being used, where R0 will be having the first parameter. So this first parameter, what it may be holding? It may hold a return address. Return address is required here to go back to the main function. Okay, so in your assembly language, you may have some program counter address. So when that program counter address before a subroutine being called, that will be stored in the stack pointer. So that address may be connected to or related to R0 register here. So it is not necessary to use R0 for only that condition. So it is only the example here. Then next, if you consider the remaining registers R4 to R11, so they may be used to restore, should be used to restore to the previous state before entering the function. So that means always in the program, we assume that here, this is only the example where R0 is used for returning to the main program. Then R1, R2, R3, they are meant for storing the subroutine values, and also R4 to R11 may be used. But before coming back to the main program from subroutine program, it is necessary to restore the previous values of R4 from where they have been called. So we will see this in the coming slides anyway. And in order to have this, so we can use the instruction push and pop instructions. So in the coming maybe next 2 or 3 lecture videos, you will see the demonstration video where you will get these push and pop instructions. Okay. Now considering in a simple way, let us see this example here. So if you go to this example, it is for a first simple program. So it can be something like this. So we are writing the program here, that is stack underscore top. It is the label. So it is meant for what? It is being used for, it is used as an equate value. And this is equated to what value? Stack underscore top. So this stack underscore top, it has been equated to this value. Okay. So after this, as usual, we need to use area, then followed by header code. So header code is nothing but usually what we use is the, in the case of here, the header code. So this header code may, or it should have the file name with which you have stored your program, then followed by something like code, then followed by read only. So this file name, it may be some arbitrary name. So hence we are using something like header code. Header code is the file name, you remember. So as I told earlier, you may be using a formula. So that formula is written with which program and where it is stored. If it is stored with something like xyz.asm, so here we can just use xyz. So whenever the program starts the execution, it will go there and it will execute that, or it will call that program. And otherwise, this is only the subroutine program. Just give the name here as xyz, so which you can use it later. So similarly, another thing is defined here, that is DCD, define constant data, and it is defined with respect to the label stack underscore top. So this is the stack top value. Then what we have is DCD start, define constant data and start. So now here after this, what we have is the entry. So this entry is nothing but the label which is present in the C file. So we add two startup files, .asm and .c file, wherein this entry is nothing but it is entering this ASM program now. So in our usual case, we have used underscore main, right? That is the main program. So otherwise it's entry, but we should make sure that in the C subroutine, the label is also entry. So now if you go to the start here, so this is the start of the main program. So it is defined as constant data. So here what we are doing, we are initializing the registers. So we are initializing the register R0 and R1. So if you consider, R0 is being initialized with 10 and R1 is initialized with 1. So now it is a simple program to perform the addition of first 10 numbers starting from 10, that is 10, 9, 8 up to 1. So what you have to do, you have to initialize R0, that is done with the 10. Then what we have done next, we have initialized the another register R0. So initially we will add up these two value. So once we add up these two value, then we have to reduce the R0 value. Then this procedure has to be repeated how many times? 10 times. So now if you consider the next line, what we have is the loop. So this loop, after this loop only you can write this instruction also. Here what is being done, we are adding the numbers, the register contents R1 comma R0. So R1 will be what now? 10. So what we are doing, we are reducing the R0 value. So we don't have something like decrement or increment instruction here. So what we can do is, we can use subtract R0 with 1, that means 10 minus 1. So this will be 9 now. So now it will check. So now here we have the example of branching instruction also, BNE. B is nothing but branch, NE stands for not equal. So not equal means which flag will be checked? The zero flag. So if the zero flag is enabled, that means what now? R0 value is zero. Hence we have used here the subscript yes. So if you don't use yes, then you cannot monitor the flags, we know. So B and E. So now R0 value is 9. So hence zero flag is still zero only. So it will come back here. Yes. So now this will be again R1 comma R0 means R1 will be loaded with what now? 9 plus 10. So like that it will be repeated till R0 becomes 0. Once it becomes 0 means we have added the numbers 10 to 1. So once it is 0, it has to go to the next line. So once it is, the 0 flag is activated. Then what it will do, again we have a label called as dead loop. So this dead loop, where it is present here. B means branch followed by label. So it will be an infinite label. So this is a single line instruction. You can consider dead loop space B, again space dead loop. So it will be executing this continuously. So no more addition will be possible. So after this, if you reset it, it will end the program. So this is how we are able to add the first 10 numbers. But here the question comes, how C and assembly level language are interfaced? So they are interfaced in this area. So you are writing the assembly program, but for something like calling the stack and startup program, the startup programs here, so we require the C program also. So we are just calling that, and this is the assembly program anyway. So this is how it is done. Okay, next. Now if you consider a subroutine program, a simple subroutine to output a character that could be something like this. So again the same thing here, we are initially defining some labels and we are equating them all to these values, the same thing. Then we are using some label, something like put C. Put C means put character, it is a C code now, right? So what it has to put here? So here we are using the push instructions. So as we discussed earlier, what we are pushing, the contents of R1, R2 and link register to the stack pointer. Then what we are doing, we are loading, LDR means loading R1 with the this label. This label is what now? UART 0 underscore flag. So UART underscore 0 flag means this will call this address where the subroutine program is written for UART 0 flag checking. Then after that it has to wait whether the flag is enabled or disabled. Then we are checking put wait loop. So these are only the general examples, so nothing to do with the conditions here. How you should understand how we can call a C program, or how we can write a subroutine program, C and assembly level language, how they are interacting with each other. Next, what we have here is LDR. So we can see here all these are what the instructions written in assembly level language. So this subroutine here, what we have called, it may be in C language. So we are loading R2 with the address pointed by R1. So R1 is holding what now? The base address of UART0. Now it is available in R2. So we are checking now the flag of the this one, the UART, whether it is active or no. So it may be having some bit number 20. Okay. So next, if it is activated, that means, so again, whether it is equal to 20 means whenever the UART flag is activated, the value 20 will be stored here in the base address. So that value is being compared with the R2 here. So if it is activated, then what it has to do, it has to check here. How to check? So again we are using the BNE. So BNE here, this instruction, then it will check if whether it is equal to 20. If it is 20, then zero flag will be activated. So if it is there, then where it has to jump? It has to jump to put C wait loop. So put C wait loop means here. If it is busy, that it will come here. If the flag is raised, it will execute the next instruction. So we know the UART execution, you are to will raise the flag first, then it will receive the data. So if the flag is now active, then this instruction will be executed. So R1 will be loaded with the UART 0 data, and data may be present in some other address. So this is the address. It may be a character or something. Okay. Then what we are doing? So usually in a UART we send the data, something like if you want to send hello, H-E-L-L-O, H-E-L-L-O, each character will take 1 byte. So that 1 byte value has to be stored. So where the value is available? Value is available in the one of the register, that is here, R0, character to send. Input is available here, source is here, and where it should be sent, it should be sent to the UART data address. So source comma destination, store a byte. Then after that, what we are doing, the values which we have pushed, we are popping them, R1, R2 and program counter. Okay, so instead of link register, they have, here we have used program counter, because R1 and R2 are being used in the subroutine program. Before that, you can store the R1 and R2 contents in the stack pointer here. And once the job is done, you can get back these values. You can get back these values from SP by popping them here, right? And in the same way, we can use that subroutine to build a number of functions to display the messages. So if you go here, we are using what now, put yes. So put the subroutine. So that stands for subroutine. Again, the same thing. First push the register contents which are using in your subroutine program, R0 and R1. So they are being pushed to stack pointer. Then what the required function will be carried out. So here it is not any specific program here. It is only the general program for understanding. So if you take R1 is being used here. So R1 and R0 should appear here. So R1 is loaded with R0. Then some byte value is stored, R0 is loaded with the byte address pointed by the R1 base address plus 1. So that value is being stored in R0. Then what we have, another example for compare here. Compare branch if 0. That means if R0 value is 0, then it has to compare this. So if the character is null, go to end. So it has to go to this label here, right? So if R0 value is 0, so it may come here and it may end the program. Otherwise, what it has to do? So it has to execute the next line instruction. What we have, branch and link. What it has to link, if the characters are there. So if I am writing H-E-L-L-O, after sending H-E-L-L-O, next is blank. So if the next character is blank, so it will come here. Otherwise, it will go to put C again. The things will be repeated. Then next, what is next? What is the next thing? Branch puts loop. So this loop will be executed. Next character will be called. So this is how the subroutine is being called here. You have to understand this. Okay. So like this, many examples we can have. So here is the example of hello world. So in the same way as I explained, you take this as an homework or an assignment or a practice program. So here I will give you the hints. So this is the label field. These are the declaration fields. So here, instead of sending or instead of sending the register directly to the stack, you may clear the contents. So the thing here is we have to send hello world. Okay, so it is the character here, hello world. So which all registers are being used, R1 and R0, so they should be pushed first. Then the same thing again, what we have done, the same thing again we are using. So this is a complete subroutine, this is the subroutine, you can see put C, and this entire space is same as this subroutine what we discussed earlier, right? The same thing here. Next, in the same way, even you can send the hexa values also. So this is for UART 0 initialization example here. You can check out this same thing again. Check here which registers are being pushed, R0 to R3, totally 4 registers. So R0, R1, R2 and R3. So those registers should appear in this program, which is acting like a subroutine program here, right? Then, so understand these labels here. Put C means for character, put S for subroutine. Both are used in a subroutine program. So this is the first subroutine to display the hexadecimal values. So in order to display the hexadecimal values, how many digits you want? 4. So that is the reason why we are using the registers R0 to R3 also. And R0 initially what we are using, branch and link, put C. So put C, you don't find the put C program here. Where it is available? It is available here. So this program is being called now. It is present in some directory of your working library. So from there it will read program. So here we are avoiding typing these lines of program. This much area is being saved. So if you call these things, you can use that. So next, we are again just calling what after executing that, move R1 with 8. So why 8? So we are using R1 as a counter. Next, move R2 comma hash 28. So rotate offset. So it is for the rotation. So why we are rotating the values? So rotate left is not there. So instead of that, if you rotate right, that will give you rotate left by 4 bits, right? So like this, it is being used. Okay, same thing here again, the same condition. So please go through this program. Then even we can use, so right till now here we have used the program memory, even you can use the data memory also. So the how to use that data memory, you can give define constant data anywhere here or here, and you can use that. Okay, so these things, just go through these programs so you will understand that. But keep in mind which all registers are being used, they should be pushed first or they should be available in the stack. So if they are not pushed onto the stack, then the data will be overwritten, right? So that is the concept here. So this is the last part now what we have here in the second module. So in the next lectures you will be seeing the demonstration videos of the instructions. Okay, thank you.